Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Welcome back to another session of UTC Talks. I'm so pleased to be with you today and to have the chance to introduce our guest speaker for today's UTC Talk. Before we begin, please do note that this session is recorded and the questions may be raised after the discussion. Today's guest speaker is currently the senior executive in the Ministry of Transport, Communication and Information Technology in Oman. He has more than 20 years experience working with people in junior, senior, expert and leadership position in the field of information technology. He has developed and managed numerous IT projects and systems which is implemented by the Omani government, and one of those is the digital transformation aligned with Oman 2040 vision. He is a PhD holder specialized in information, communication, and technology, as well experienced and certified in his field of expertise, and certified also as IT audit quality management and as a bulletproof manager. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming Dr. Salem Al-Shu'aili. Dr. Salem, the floor is yours.
شكراً دكتور محفوظة, شكراً ما خسرتي, بارك الله فيك. السلام عليكم جميعاً, وأسعد الله صباحكم. طبعاً بالنسبة للحضور, ما أدري هل هو في حضور بيكون في زيادة أو هذا فقط الحضور المتوقع. ما أدري بالنسبة للتسجيل, ربما أزهار عندها يعني بالنسبة للتسجيل, لكن بالنسبة للمحاضرة طبعاً بتمشي حسب الجدول إن شاء الله. بالنسبة للمحاضرة, just show it. Inshallah, we are going to talk about harnessing IR4, طبعاً industrial revolution for technologies in crisis management. Just before I am starting, the presentation slide will be in English, but I received many messages and call that if it can be also the talk will be in Arabic. So I'm going to mix between Arabic and English. The slide that is already explained in English, no need to repeat it the same, so I can translate it to Arabic, inshallah. And I think most of the audience are Arabic speakers, as I am seeing now. تسخير تقنيات الثورة الصناعية الرابعة في إدارة الأزمات والكوارث. طبعاً تقنيات الثورة الصناعية وجميع التقنيات بتختلف استخداماتها ما بين أو مجال استخداماتها. فمثلاً في إدارة الأزمات, لابد في إدارة الأزمات إحنا معانا احتياط, يعني احتياطات لازمة فيها. وطبعا المختصين اكيد يعني كتبوا واسهبوا في هذا المجال, هي تكون قبل الازمه واثناء الازمه وبعد الازمه. لو جينا طبعا بالنسبه للكرايسيس مانجمنت اللي هي الكرايسيس, طبعا اوريدي اكسبلين هير ان انجلش. بالنسبه للكرايسيس اللي هي الازمات, الازمات اي كارثه او اي حادثه تكون عليها يعني باد امباكت على سواء على المجتمع, والمجتمع طبعا بأقسامه, يعني الناس, البيئة, الثقافة, أيضا إذا كان مهددة للأمن, أو أيضا باد امباكت على الاقتصاد, يعني أيضا على الاقتصاد والفاينانشال, هذا يعني تسمى كارثة يعني أو تسمى أزمة, وقد تتحول لو ما تم احتوائها إلى كارثة. وطبعا نعرف أن إدارتها وتكلفتها لو ما كان احتوائها من البداية بيكون عالي وغالي أيضا بالنسبة للمبالغ. طبعا بالنسبة regarding the crisis, it can be classified into three things or three fields. يعني there is a human made, I can say human made crisis. Also there is natural crisis and biological crisis. And from our experience, عايشنا, we have lived with all of these crises. بالنسبة للبيولوجيكال crisis, we are still living with the COVID-19 and COVID-20, اللي هو البانديميك, الكوفيد, الفيروس اللي منتشر حول العالم, وشفنا كيف عمل شل, يعني all the life has been paralyzed and totally and completely. سو هذا يعتبر يعني اعتقد كارثه عالميه صارت. وبالنسبه اللي عايشناه, what we have lived here in Oman about the cyclone, شاهين cyclone, and before it was Gonu, also Gonu cyclone. فهذا natural and biological crisis. Human made, I can also say that, like for example, a fire or technology, يعني أيضا الحوادث اللي تحدث في التقنية, يعني من يوم بيوم اختراقات, الاختراقات أيضا مكلفة, يعني لو صار يعني اختراقات وتمادل في الاختراقات أيضا ربما تصير إلى كارثة بالنسبة للدولة, لأنه بتكلف الدولة كثيرة. يعني حتى رايحين نشوف بالنسبة للداتا, يعني الـ owned by the government, لو تم اختراقها يعني تصير كارثة. أما بالنسبة لإدارة crisis management, طبعا how يعني أو كيف ممكن إن إحنا ندير هذه الأزمة, يعني بدل ما توصل إلى كارثة وتكلف أشياء كثيرة, طبعا يكون إدارتها قبل الأزمة وأثناء الأزمة وبعد الأزمة. وطبعا هذا الهدف من هذا السيشن إن شاء الله, نشوف كيف بعض هذه التقنيات ممكن نستخدمها وتساعد, it will help to mitigate the impact of any crisis. فحسب ما نشوف حتى في التعاريف, طبعا التعاريف موجودة أمامنا, no need to repeat them again. طبعا بالمناسبة, I'm not going to see the chat during the presentation. Plus, if you have any question or any comments, please put your pen in your fingers and paper in front of you. Write the question, the comment, the suggestion, whatever. At the end, we are all learning together. We will discuss, inshallah. For IR, الثورة الصناعية الرابعة, Industrial Revolution. طبعا, is a term coined first in 2016 by Klaus Schwab. وهذا ألف كتاب, he has published a book about fourth industrial revolution. هو هذا الشخص founder and executive chairman of the World Economic Forum. إيش هي هذه الثورة الفور آي آر؟ we can call it as a digital revolution. Why? Because we stand on the brink of a technological revolution that will fundamentally alter the way we live, work, and relate to one another in its scale, scope, and complexity. The transformation, of course, this is for IR, is a part of digital transformation. I don't, of course, most of you, maybe some of you didn't attend last session, it was about digital transformation, but we shouldn't assume that all of you attended this or read about that one. So this is for IR, is a part of digital transformation. Digital transformation, transforming from one situation to a better situation. And we'll see what is the factor that it can scale or with these things. The transformation will be unlike, of course, anything humankind has experienced before. And we don't yet know just how it will unfold. But one thing is clear to all of us, or to maybe to people who work in this and في استشراف المستقبل, the response to it must be integrated and comprehensive, involving all stakeholders of the global polity. Yeah, and when we say about the digital revolution or the digital transformation, it should be there is an integration between all parties, from the public and private sectors to academia and civil society, or to environment, or to the culture, whatever. And we know about if there is any change, we should manage the changes in five factors, which is people, processes, technologies, culture, and environment. قبل ما ندخل ونوصل على الثورة الصناعية الرابعة, كيف وصلنا إلى الثورة الصناعية الرابعة؟ وليش سميت بالثورة الصناعية الرابعة؟ طبعاً بدأت الثورة الصناعية الأولى مثل ما هو بين in front of us من 1760 to 1840. يعني وهذا كان استخدام الماء و steam power to mechanize the production.
Excuse me, Dr. Salem. Yes, we have other attendees. Yeah, we have attendees who cannot speak Arabic. يعني
who just joined. Yeah, Dr. Mahfouza, yani I said that wherever there is an English slide, so I can explain it in Arabic because they can read the English one.
Okay.
فهذا بالنسبة لنواصل طبعا بالنسبة للثورة الصناعية الأولى. بعد الثورة الصناعية الأولى رحنا إلى الثورة الصناعية الثانية. الثورة الصناعية الثانية كانت تستخدم electric power to create mass production. بعد هذه طبعا كل هذه الثورات يعني والعراقيل اللي تواجه العالم في ذاك الأثناء وفي ذاك التاريخ يعني نفس العراقيل اللي تواجه في يعني أو نفس الأفكار أو نفس الأشياء اللي تواجه حاليا. لكن طبعا لكل فترة الحلول ما لها تختلف عن الفترة اللي بعدها. طبعا لما وصلنا إلى الثورة الصناعية الرابعة الثورة الصناعية الثالثة كان بداية انطلاقة الثورة التقنية اللي هي كانت في القطاع الاي سي تي، البناء بداية صناعة الكمبيوترات وبداية صناعة البرمجيات. طبعا في هذيك الأثناء إذا حد لحق أو شاف كان بمثابة ما مثل حاليا اللي نشوف how the IT or the gadgets has been developed and improved. And we can before we can see that the hard disk is the size of one room, one big room, but now the hard disk, the big hard disk or the size the big size of hard disk in the size of your finger. So انطلقت يعني بعدين انبثقت. كيف انبثقت الثورة الصناعية الرابعة؟ وليش سميت الثورة الصناعية الرابعة؟ وهي أصلاً امتداد we can say a prolongation of الثورة الصناعية الثالثة، لكن لابد أنها تتميز. يعني we can why today's transformation represent not merely a prolongation of the third industrial revolution but rather the arrival of a fourth and distinct one. كيف بتكون يعني هي متميزة؟ لابد أن بالسرعة والهدف وأيضاً systems impact هي تأثير على الأنظمة. فهذا اللي سميت بالثورة الصناعية why it's called fourth industrial revolution because of the velocity and the scope and systems impact. The speed of the current breakthrough has no historical precedent when compared with the previous industrial revolution. The fourth is evolving at an exponential rather than a linear pace. So it is disrupting almost every industry in every country. وهذا شيء ملموس وواضح في حياتنا اليومية وحسب التطور اللي نشوفه من فيلد إلى آخر. طبعاً مواصلة لهذه الأشياء احنا شفنا كيف يعني كيف انبثقت الثورة الصناعية الرابعة وكيف وصلنا الثورة الصناعية الرابعة. And we said it's not just a prolongation of third industrial revolution. Here the same. From one to two to three and four. This is the four. It used these technologies. This technology what we are using it today. It's part of or a component of الثورة الصناعية الرابعة 4IR like artificial intelligence, cloud computing and IoT, big data, location GPS, mobile devices, augmented reality and virtual reality, smart sensors, all these technologies are part or the element of 4IR. طبعا عشان تشكيل او عشان to call it is a 4IR and we said it's how it can be a distinct from the previous one. It has to be a digitalization integration of a value chain, digitalization of products and services offering, and also digital business models and customer access should be present so it will be easy. And now we see how many models it's been inherited and integrated with all these technologies. To adopt 4IR, it's a combination between digital world, virtual world, and the physical world. First, we have to build our strategy. After building a strategy, we have to create the opportunity for these technologies, not just building not just developing the technologies and we don't know where to use, or just buying a ready technology and there is no use for it. And also we have to create also pilot environment or platform to test these technologies. And then after we have been or build the strategy and create the opportunity and offer the pilot platform, we have to educate the team. and learn them all the skills that required for these technologies. And then at the end, we are adapting the technologies in our environment. The future trends of 4IRs, as we see here, 10% of people will be wearing clothes connected to the internet. We don't know when it's going to come, but now we see how the bracelets and lots of things, even in your watch, in your mobile, but now it will come to the cloth, maybe. 80% will have unlimited sponsor backup space in the cloud, and this we live with that one. There will be 1 trillion sensors connected to the internet. If we see now how many sensors are connected to the internet, how many devices are connected to the internet, and you can check that in a website that's called Status. So you will find how many, it's a billion and billions. 80% of the world's population will have internet presence. I think now it's more, but according to the last updated slides, it's 80%, but we will find maybe more than 80%. The first automobile entirely produced with 3D printers. 90% of the world's population will own a smartphone, and we live with this one. 90% of the world's population will have internet access. 10% of all vehicles on the roads will be driverless. سيارات ذاتية القيادة, it's already available. And has been used, most of these vehicles use what's called use IT. That's already, or what's called vehicles using telematics. So we have seen it in China during the pandemic, COVID-19, they already use that one. More than 50% of home appliances will be connected to internet, and more rides will be made on shared cars than on private cars. So maybe more and more the trends will coming. The opportunity of 4IR, optimization and automation lead to enhanced productivity, real-time data for real-time supply chain and real-time economy. Of course, all of this is the opportunity and benefit of 4IR technologies. Maybe we can see it is representing in one technology, and we will see it later on, how it's connected to all of these technologies and how it gives and steering the other technologies or the other assets or the other devices. The third one, advanced maintenance and monitoring possibilities will enable greater business continuity. Fourth, real-time monitoring, IoT-enabled quality improvement, and cobots, which are collaborative robots, will lead to higher quality products. The fifth one, superior sustainability and better working conditions. Sixth, earn the trust and loyalty, the modern consumer with the personalization opportunities. طبعاً, yeah, let me now convert to just to explain this one. تقنيات الثورة الصناعية الرابعة طبعاً يعني أحدثت أو تم خلق هذه التقنيات من أجل طبعاً الراحة. يحس بالراحة فعلاً اللي يستخدمها. يعني كثير من التقنيات كنا ما نستخدمها لما استخدمناها فعلاً شفنا الفرق ما بين الحياة سابقاً والحياة باستخدام التقنيات. وأقرب حاجة اللي هو سمارت فونز اللي الحين in front of us or our life in smart phones now. يعني كيف الحياة قبل والحياة حالياً. طبعا the current generation in the current era maybe ما يصدقوا يعني الحياة اللي كانوا عايشينها سابقا وكيف كان التواصل وما بين الحياة اللي الحين وفعلا نقول هل فعلا الأجيال القادمة ممكن تعيش من دون هذا أو لابد أنه في يكون تطور أحسن من هذا التطور. طبعا ندخل إلى تقنيات اللي هي تقنيات الثورة الصناعية الرابعة. طبعا عندي ثلاث تقنيات اللي هي او ثلاثه اشياء ثلاث جزئيات اللي هي المحرك الاساسي للثوره الصناعيه الرابعه. لما نجي على طبعا على الارتفيشال انتليجنس, why we say that الارتفيشال انتليجنس والبيج داتا والاي او تي which is internet of things are key drivers behind the ongoing digital transformation and will play an increasingly important role in all phases of disaster management and resiliency development. لأن احنا نتكلم احنا we are talking here about the crisis and disasters, so هذا they will play the big role in managing these things. طبعا AI هي is not a gadget or يعني ما devices, هذا مثل techniques تدخل في تطوير هذا الديفايسز وكيف يكون الريسبونس. نفس الحاله البيج داتا, البيج داتا هي مثل تكنيكس عشان تو ستور اند تو ريسيف اول ذا داتا اند مانج ذيس داتا اند ات ذا اند برودوس ذا انفورميشن ذا انفورميشن ويز ريكوايرد ذا اكشن ذات ذا اكشن اتسلف از ذا اي او تي اند وي ويل سي. ما نستعجل على الامور. طبعا بالنسبه للارتفيشال انتليجنس is a powerful tools which can be very useful against crisis. مثل ما قلنا it is an application similar to machine learning, computer vision and natural language processing which is NLP which can instruct computers to use models based on big data for recognizing, explaining and predicting the pattern. ايش هي التايز مالها؟ طبعا في الارتفيشال انتليجنس نشوف مثلا في الاكسبيرت سيستمز اللي هي الانظمه او خلينا نقول احنا الواحد يقول في العاب احنا نلعب الكمبيوترز هذا من ضمن ايش يستخدم هذا يستخدم الارتفيشال انتليجنس الذكاء الاصطناعي ايضا نيورال نتوركس الجينيتك الجوريثم انتليجنت ايجنت والفيرتشوال رياليتي كل هذه الاشياء بتستخدم ارتفيشال انتليجنس. يعني احنا نشوف الحين اذا فيه اي تقنيه موجوده بتقول لك هذه اتس ان انتليجنت سيستم. ليش انتليجنت؟ إيذر يعني بزنس انتليجنت أو الارتفيشال انتليجنس at the end it's a technique for an intelligence. The element of AI artificial intelligence there is two types techniques and application area. طبعا في pattern matching الأنماط مطابقة الأنماط يعني ومن ضمنها مثلا الحين نلاحظ في we have face recognition camera مو يعني مباشرة once it's captured the face it will analyze that face it will process it and at the end we'll see it's matching or not matching it's allowed or not allowed inference searching and knowledge representation for the application area this is the whole of the application area which can AI be used. تطبيقاتها طبعا تطبيقاتها في عده جوانب طبعا جوانب الحياه جميعا wherever there is a technology the AI can embed in that technologies and can be integrated education entertainment law resource employment healthcare public safety service and home robots transportation wherever there is a technology the AI can be integrated. Now for the big data. What is the big data? And as I said before, I selected this one because هذا لأن المحركات الرئيسية لتقنيات الثورة الصناعية الرابعة. طبعاً إحنا نتكلم الحين عن تقنيات الثورة الصناعية الرابعة تمهيداً to pave the way عشان نتكلم إيش هذا فائدة التقنيات في الكرايسيس مانجمنت وليش هذا بالضبط؟ لأن حنشوف تقنيات أخرى وكلها معتمدة على هذا الأشياء كلها تستخدم it's used either artificial intelligence or big data. Or IoT, which is Internet of Things. The big data is analytic techniques, as we say, it's not a device, which is very much suitable to track and control the worldwide crisis. This technology provides the basis for a faster and almost real-time evaluation of decision-making. نلاحظ الحين إحنا أحياناً في مشاريع بنقرأ عنها. يقول لك ان البيانات الضخمه يعني احنا نسوي مشروع معتمد على البيانات الضخمه على سرعه اتخاذ القرار. ليش سرعه اتخاذ القرار؟ لان احنا نعرف يستخدم فيها الارتفيشال انتليجنس ما بيكون مبني على رغبه شخص معين لا او مثلا يعني بس خلينا نقول يعني I am sitting in my chair and suddenly يعني somebody bring me to take any decision and based on my temper I will say no, it's approved or not approved. So based on what? It must be based on the data in front of you. So at the end, the data can judge you either to approve it or not to approve it. And of course, big database is the same as a database. But why? يعني, when we are measuring for the database, we will see the measuring type. Don't say about one organization or one country. So we call this big data because maybe more than 1 million or maybe a trillion or billion of transactions happening, going and coming in this database. It's not like maintaining 5,000 records per a minute or per an hour or per a day. This is not a big data. It is a simple database or a warehouse. Big data units, how the big data measured. We heard about bit بايت، كيلو بايت، ميجا بايت، جيجا بايت، and terabyte. But have you heard about petabyte, exabyte, zettabyte, and utabyte? So have you heard about this one? This is the future. When we talk about zettabyte or social network, imagine how many transactions, how many records is going to the database, is saved to the database. How many like, how many retweets, how many shared, how many new posts, and regarding the post, how many videos, how many images. So this is a size. You know, we know that the size of video is more than the size of the images, is more than the size of normal text. So this is why it's called zettabyte. Utabyte, as I heard, I found that it's the future of the big data. So it's 1,024 zettabyte, and each one is doubling the others. This is a facts, real facts of the data. We can see it, and even we can find search in the internet for the current one. Maybe this one, if somebody now opening any statistical website, he will find maybe different than this one, because maybe this one it was yesterday, but today is different. Why? Because people are not sitting idle. There is lots of transaction happening and moving. Look, for example, Twitter use sent out 682 million tweet per day. See for the Facebook, see for the emails, for the videos, internet users, Instagram posts, and all the, and even for the search. Do you think that when we are searching, just searching and no one know what we are searching? How many times you are searching on one thing? And it happened to you when you are opening any application, and it's advertisement coming to you for that one which you search. So you will ask yourself, how they know that I was searching for this one? This is the artificial intelligence happening, and your record was saved. طبعا الواقع يختلف. يعني حتى المقارنات مثلا شوفوا في internet users in 2014 comparing to 2016 to compare to 2019. But what about today? We are in 2021. We will see why we need to know about all these things. Because to call it as a big data, we need, as before, to see the size and the volume plus the value of the big data. See the value of the big data. You say, most of you people say it's data. Why we are caring about this data? Is it really worth to maintain all this data? Yes, because the data, the big data, is the fuel of the future. Currently we know what the fuel is, the oil. But in the future, it will be this one. The data is the fuel of the future. In 2021, it was estimated, or it's estimating, it's 64 billion, of course, a billion, not 64 only dollar, 64 billion dollar. It's expected in 2025 by 90 billion dollars. This is the value of the big data. And who is utilizing this big data? Lots of companies, lots of people, lots of internal security. The source of the data, from where? Images and media, clickstream, social network, of course, HTML, the websites, sensors, emails, locations, and most of the databases. If we consolidate lots of databases, for example, in the country, we have around 200 databases. We consolidate all together. So how many records and the transaction per hours? This is the five V's of big data. هذا اللي يميز البيج داتا. الفوليوم, الفيلوسيتي, الفاريتي, الفيراسيتي, and the value. All these five V's of the big data. So if the volume is high volume, so of course it's a big data. If the velocity must be high velocity. It must be high speed, with the high speed. It's not we call it just a big data, but the speed is so slow. And الفاريتي التنوع. Of course, it's not one thing. We have images, we have videos, we have transaction, we have text, we have different things. Veracity, الموثوقية, يعني accuracy under TNT of the data and data sources. يعني it's not a garbage, it's not just a garbage. Value, قيمة هذه البيانات. هل اللي فعلا لها قيمة, there is a value for this data or no value. طبعا بالنسبه للبيج داتا ورك فلو, يعني ما هي فقط is not just collecting the data. Okay, what's next? That's why we are calling big data. And when you want to use the artificial intelligence in it, simple. If you are following this diagram in front of you, yes, I expanded it, but I will give you in three things. Collect, after collecting, processing and filtering. Filter this data. After that one, analyze the data. After analyzing the data, there is one thing left, but it's not in big data. It's not the data. It's not the role of the database or the data or the artificial intelligence here. It's produce the action. What is that action? This is the action. It will steer one of the 4IR technologies. So see here, business case evaluation, identification, acquisition, aggregation, validation, extraction, analysis, visualization, and the analysis result. The same, if I have a database, that we are embedded artificial intelligence in that database, and there is a decision maker would like to take any decision, collect the information. Of course, he was just by a click, but what does mean that a click and he will give the decision for that one? A click, of course, on that click, behind that there is a triggers to be fired, to collect the data, analyze, process and filter the data, process the data and give the output for that one. Either yes or no, approve or not approve. Yes, we can go ahead or not. This is what we call actionable intelligence. يعني معانا مثلا, we have in the country, the population of the cities is distributed. In this city is high population, that city low population. And the government decide to build a hospital or build a schools. So based on what to build the school, in this city or in that city? So we have to collect the population, the other factors, the other things. So based on that one, the intelligence analysis will produce the decision for the decision makers. IoT. Yes, we are coming here to the IoT. It's the key technology for the 4IR, for Industrial Revolution, للثورة الصناعية الرابعة. طبعا هو هذا المحرك الأساسي, Internet of Things. Why we call it Internet of Things? لأن Internet with Things هي الأشياء, technologies. If things هي devices. If things هي, هنشوف إن things هي reports, if things هي drones, if things هي decision reports, smarts, whatever. كل هذه الأشياء هي بنشوفها إن هي things. طبعا Internet of Things is an automated solution that has resulted in tremendous growth in automated manufacturing, management of assets. It comprises of collection, transfer, analytics, and storage of data. Not only that one. Of course, I told you, for the big data, collect, process, analyze, at the end what? At the end, the action. This is the action in the part of IoT. The action, it can be give a steering or give an instruction, for example, to people, or give an instruction to a technology. And there is an action should be happening. So that's why the بناء, لما نقول smart city, what does it mean smart city? There is no human interaction. Smart city, everything is smart. Just giving you alert and notification. You are an end user receiving just alerts and notification. For example, if I would like to go to my work, I will put the destination of my work on my navigation tool or navigation system apps. So he will check by what? By communicating to the sensor in the road, in the traffic. Is it the right time to leave my home? It will give me, the reply will give him as an alert to me that not, this is not the right time. So wait, because there is a traffic, there is, for example, an accident, there is a traffic jam, there whatever there is in the road. So this is the IoT. So collecting of data is done with the help of sensors incorporated in mobile phones, reports, whatever, and we said that it's a sensors. The data collected is then sent for analytics and decision making at the end, analyzing and decision making to the central cloud server. So then it will steer or give an instruction, and the action or the intelligent action will be happening. Of course, this is Kevin Ashton, the founder of IoT, the first person. He said that turn the world into data first. It will give you the micro decision, not only general decision, the micro decision. For example, even for the legalization, we have how many rules? We have how many legals now in front of us? So most of these legals are interpreted as per the legal department people understanding, and you will find this one is interpreted different than the other one. But if I have an intelligent system, I will put my case based on the legal that already uploaded in the system. He will give me the result. This is the micro decision. Information is a great way to reduce waste and increase efficiency, definitely. This one, collect, process, analyze, and act. This is the IoT. Application of IoT on people, smart homes, retails, offices, factories, cars, cities, and traffic. See here the same, this is the application of IoT. In IoT, away from the crisis management, now we'll start for the crisis management. IoT in Oman has been implemented in several places. يعني المرة الماضية كان وزارة الأوقاف Ministry of Awqaf implemented in the all the masjids. So if there is a sensor, if there is no people, no movement in the masjid, it will turn off all the electricity, because we have found how many mosques has been left with all the ACs being on, lights are on, fans are on. So if the sensor feels there is no person there, it will turn off all the electricity. So this is one. And also there are lots of areas have been implemented. And also for the artificial intelligence, and you have heard about the early examination of the chest breast, the Ministry of Health is using the artificial intelligence, and it was more accurate than the human one. The accuracy of it was more than 94%. So let us move now for the benefits of 4IR. Of course, this is benefits in crisis management. Before we start, this is to tell you why we should use the 4IR technologies. Why we should harness the 4IR technologies in crisis management. This is the benefit of it. Provide risk and relief parts in time using smart supply chain. لعملية الإنقاذ والإغاثة. ايضا روبوت ودرونز عشان يتحركن الى الاماكن اللي ما يستطيع يوصلهم. وطبعا رايحين نشوف انه مثلا شفنا في ايام اعصار شاهين during the شاهين cyclone there are some places it will يعني totally isolated and even the government no one knows what happening there. Use virtual reality and augmented reality for training and awareness purpose للتدريب والتوعيه. هذا قبل بنشوف قبل واثناء وبعد ايش الفائده. Promote a flexible working environment. Even these technologies help people to perform daily life work during the lockdown. يعني خلنا نقول هنا the best example now. We are giving this, or we are taking this session, and not a live interaction, but a live through online. So يعني هذا واحدة من الفوائد مالها هي. يعني you can work from anywhere at any time. You can deliver, you can meet people like you are in your office, you are in your class. Provide, and شفنا ايضا لما كان working from home, يعني لما كان implementing working from home, وكنا نتمنى انه فعلا توصل هذا علشان to be more innovative idea coming for working from home. ونتمنى فعلا يتخذ يعني او في يكون تعديل على اساس في يكون هناك العمل working from home او telework. بحيث انه فعلا في تطبيقات جاهزه وايضا بيس ان انتليجنس سيستم provide several innovation with the help of advanced manufacturing and digital technologies. الحين تكلمنا عن هذا. ايضا researchers and specialists can employ these technologies for social and media platform to identify unusual information. احنا شفنا طبعا واحده من التقنيات اللي الحين ظهرت اللي هي من السوشيال ميديا. فاحنا شفنا الكثير من الرومرز الاشاعات اللي ظهرت مثلا فقدان او اشاعات كثيره خاصه during the crisis. يعني الناس خلاص كانت بير مور هارمفور انفورميشن. يعني يجي اي شخص anyone coming and post any word or any sentence without any reference, any official reference. So هذا الريسيرشر يعني of course يستخدمه طبعا intelligence system. The intelligence system can filter this information and only publish the right information and the right data. Agencies gain a clear picture of operations with real-time feasibility of data. At the same time, يعني شوف كل هذه الأشياء. Agencies can extract current and historic data from multiple sources, transform it into rapidly accessible, actionable intelligence for faster and better informed decisions. هذا اللي تكلمنا عنه. إن استخدام هذه التقنيات في إدارة الأزمات ما مثل استخدامها في أشياء أخرى. لأن في إدارة الأزمات أنت أثناء الأزمة يعني إحنا شفنا أعلنت حالة طوارئ. ليش هذه حالة طوارئ؟ يعني إحنا المفترض قبل الأزمة طبعاً في لجنة الطوارئ قبل الأزمة صارت. يعني تنبؤات ما تنبؤات ايش اللي صار ايش بيصير وايش بيحدث اثناء الأزمة ايش المفترض يعني نستخدم. طبعا احنا يعني ممكن واحد يقول في تقصير كثير في تقصير لانه ما كل هذه التكنولوجيا كانت مستخدمه. هنشوف ايش بعض من هذه التكنولوجيز which was or were used during the crisis. ايضا بعد هذه الازمه ايش فائده هذه التكنولوجيز. طبعا it helps in creating a single federated information hub. أيضا agencies can build an information backbone that all parties to contribute to and work from. يعني بدل ما يكون مشتتة إحنا معنا one platform الكل مشترك فيها الكل يأخذ فيها. طبعا ليش؟ لأن هذه التكنولوجيز كلها تتخاطب or communicate with one database. It increases collaboration and interoperability. Agencies gain by leveraging cutting edge technologies. بالنسبه للتقنيات اللي ممكن تستخدم اثناء او في اداره الازمات. طبعا ليش قلنا اداره الازمات ونستخدم التكنولوجيا؟ لما احنا نكون well prepared لاي ازمه لان to mitigate يعني الامباكت مال اي ازمه بدل ما تصير الى كارثه. وبعض الكوارث لا يحمد عقباها. يعني انا مثلا على تنبؤات طبعا الحين صارت الارصاد الجويه. طبعا الارصاد الجويه بينما في الحين في كثير من الشركات او كثير من الاماكن طورت انظمه بالذكاء الاصطناعي للتنبؤات اكثر يعني more precise than يعني وتستخدم ايضا في الارصاد الجويه. هذا قبل طبعا يعطى هذه البيانات. لما تكون البيانات دقيقه تكون easy to take an action يعني for decision makers for example what they need to do. يعني maybe خلنا نقول مثلا ناخذ one example. يعني if there is a cyclone so the cyclone is going to affect this area so it's easy to evacuate all people from this area to the safe place instead of letting them living there whatever. يعني طبعا في قوانين ان واحد بيقول ما في حاجه اجباريه تخرج حد من بيته بس انا الحين يعني المصلحه العامه اولى من المصلحه الخاصه في ذيك اللحظه. We have these technologies in front of us. AI and autonomous reports. وإحنا شفنا طبعاً AI وفائدتها. طبعاً إيش فائدتها رايحين نشوف قبل وبعد كل هذه الأشياء اللي هي in front of us. طبعاً بالنسبة AI and autonomous reports. طبعاً إيش فائدة AI بتكون؟ طبعاً اللي مثل ما قلنا predicts outbreak and forecast before. وطبعا نشوف هذا في شركه بريطانيه اسمها شركه ديب مايند. هذه الشركه طورت وقت ويعني طورت البرنامج تعرف انه وقت وكميه الامطار وايش اضرار هذه الامطار يعني باستخدام الذكاء الاصطناعي. كما ايضا in Qatar there is one institute for artificial intelligence incorporated with the Massachusetts University in US طوروا ايضا develop another application يتنبأ بالحوادث يعني protect for the crisis before it happening. فيعني الحمد لله يعني هذا في تطور يعني في استخدام هذا الـ AI. طبعا can be deployed for patrolling the areas to confirm that the people are following the orders. هذا يعني طبعا هذا اللي هي can be deployed وين رايحين نشوفه يعني deploy either على الروبوتكس أو deploy على مثلا على الدرونز. بالنسبة للـ IoT the internet of things طبعا مثل ما نشوف tracing the origin of the of an outbreak وتي يعني بالنسبة لل يعني ما يحتاج مثل ما تكلمت أنا الـ IoT Internet of Things هي بحد ذاتها هي المشغل الحقيقي لتقنيات الثورة الصناعية الرابعة لأنها عبارة كلها عن سنسر مترابطات مع بعض بالإنترنت. هذا السنسر ما أي سنسر يعني مشترط أنه فيها يكون IP address لأن ما ممكن أجي أتخاطب الحين أنا مثل ما لاحظين ما ممكن أتخاطب ما بين الموبايل مالي وما بين الكمبيوتر تبعي ما فقط تعالوا ناداه فلان وقال له نعم لا في IP address فأنت كأنك تنادي بالIP address هذاك اسمه عنوانه هو يتواصل معه. طبعا الIoT وظيفتها هي يعني الحد من potential damages from the disaster وأيضا يعني بعوض عن هذا اللي أمامنا ensure أيضا immediate and suitable assistance to the victims وتين effective and rapid recovery مباشرة. لو جينا وشفنا استخدامات طبعا هي هذا الIoT رايحين نشوف يعني في البريفنشن اللي هي بيفور والبريبريشن والريسبونس والريكفر. في البريفنشن ان يوزنج ريل تايم سنسر بيس داتا كريتيكال انفراستراكشر بروتكشن هازارد ميتيجيشن ثرو مونيتورينج اوف ذا انفايرمنت. يعني مثلا خلنا نقول ان احنا مثلا في كميه امطار رايحه تنزل معانا في التنبؤات الحاله الجويه قالوا انه في كميه امطار موجوده معانا. طبعا هذا السنسرز اللي موجوده مثلا موجوده على الدامز ان ووتر دامز so when it reach to one level or to level certain level that sensor it will send a signal to another sensors to take an action. What is that action? Maybe to open the valve automatically to open the valve to at least to empty the dam at that time instead of explosion or anything happening to that dam. This is what happening of this or the use of these sensors. Even imagine anything in your ecosystem in the life. So what we have where we can embed these sensors, where to use it in the crisis, in the cyclone itself. And in anywhere, if there is a sensor, something it's required to call, for example, a robot or to call the drones, maybe even to measure the air pollution and تلوث الجوي. So if it reached to some amount, it will call, for example, it will send the signals to the cloud. The cloud see that is required, for example, after analyzing required a drone to go and spray the medicine for that or spray anything to calm down or to bring down that the haze or the anything. So this is how the sensor are work and communicate between all the devices. In the preparation, use of sensor technology to address a real-time stock and supplies replenishment, spares, planning, and automated end-to-end processing. Of course, asset track and trace. Even for the crisis, what is used for the crisis? إحنا شفنا مثلاً during Shaheen cyclone, في مفقودين. طبعاً قبل خلنا يعني talk in this way in clear way. احنا لو كان معانا تنبؤات سابقه انه هذه الاشياء اللي بتصير وهذه كميه الامطار اللي بتصير وهذه المناطق راح تتضرر طبعا ديسيشن يعني ديسيشن ميكرز ويل تيك ا ديسيشن انه اخلاء عمليه اخلاء لهذه المناطق ما بي تكسير بريك داون ايفن ذا انفراستراكشر ان سيرتن اريا. ليش؟ ان انا اتفادى الخطر بمخاسير بسيطه أفضل إن المخاسير it's unexpected، يعني it's unexpected. فبالتالي صار هذا الأشياء. بعد طبعاً during أنا أتواصل، أنا أعرف الأشخاص، يعني مثلاً الأشخاص اللي موجودين في مناطق معينة ممكن عندهم شيب معين أو عن طريق الموبايل تبعهم I can trace them and track they are after يعني after السايكلون أو after الكرايسيس أستطيع أتأكد. يعني الحين إحنا يعني يقال إنه في مفقودين الحين ما موجودين، لو كان معي أنا مثلاً هذا السنسرز إنه to track these people I will know where exactly they are، يعني إنه ممكن لبسهم إياه، يعني مثل الموبايلز ممكن يفقدوا الموبايلز، لكن يعني مثلاً الأساور أو أي حاجة بحيث إن أنا ممكن إنه to track these people. أيضاً من النقطة الثانية لو في مثلاً إنه منطقة ما كانت محسوبة إنه الديزاستر والريتش دير طبعاً وفجأة تفاجأوا بهذا الديزاستر، مثلاً ممكن يرسلوا إشارة إلى ويرسل لهم مثلاً درونز أو أي حاجة على أساس عملية إنقاذ تريسكيو ديم. فهذه التقنية فائدتها، يعني التقنية قبل وأثناء وبعد، فهي كلها عملية تخاطب ما بين أجهزة، لكن لابد أن هذه التقنية تكون متوفرة وتكون يعني جاهزة والإنفراستركتشر تكون جاهزة. طبعاً رايحين نشوف إيش العراقيل التشالنجز والفيس ديس تكنولوجيز تأدبت إن أور أو إن أول إنفايرمنت نوت إن أور إنفايرمنت أونلي. طبعاً الريسبونس فيكل تراكينج أند جي إس إنتجريشن Use of sensor to monitor the movement of key personnel, situational awareness and incidents management. أيضا ما ننسى لما كان في COVID-19 احنا شفنا ان الحركة has been completely paralyzed، يعني انشلت الحركة بتاتا. طبعا كيف انشلت؟ يعني انشلت الحركة خلاص، يعني ما في movement، lockdown. ايضا في medication لابد يوصلن، فطلب medication يكون عن طريق ايش فائدة هذه التقنية what utilization مثلا drones to for transportation to deliver this medicine. Okay, مثلا في المستشفيات يعني منعوا any hand shaking hand interaction any interaction or touch between the human so the robotics can go and move or the cars vehicle that using telematics can use this one. طبعا ايش اللي يستخدموا اللي هي vehicles using telematics اللي هي using information technologies اللي self driving ذاتية القيادة. طبعا ذاتية القيادة not only by itself it's moving when I'm sending my request or there is a need that the sensors is sending there is a need or for anything or for special specific technology or specific help in this area it will send the location of that area it will send the time it will send the date so immediately when it reached to the cloud or to the server when it analyzed when that for example vehicle the vehicles using telematics will go it knows where exactly to know so because the location already sent and it knows where exactly it's required so the robotics already loaded the requirements on that vehicle see how the technology is collaborate and communicate between each another so there is no human interaction all the technologies communicate together. And in the recover use of sensors, use sensor technology for identification and authentication of beneficiaries, and use of smart cards and RFIDs for relief disbursement. Create a virtual logistic network that allow hub operators and others to monitor traffic towards and within a hub in real time and facilitate communication between all involved parties, not only one side. Going back again, so we have seen that about IoT, about big data analyzing and forecasting, big data can be highly, of course, can be highly useful for analyzing and forecasting the reach and impact of the crisis on people. From where this the data is coming, it's mentioned in the next bullet, analyzing information generated by sensors in IoT, as well as data from drones and robots. Of course, these drones and robots also sending the data, sending information, and what they have done and where they have gone. Virtual reality and AR reality. Of course, First, the benefit here in crisis, ability to make, when I'm mentioning here before, general benefit, here benefit for exactly in crisis management, ability to make people feel like they are together in the same space without the need for traveling. And it improves efficiency, upgrade the working in a group, reduce the travel costs. And we have seen that during the pandemic COVID-19 and also in the crisis, the cyclone, when all that two areas has been isolated from the others, or maybe they are not able to resume their daily tasks and daily work. Also, the extra benefit is that people can entirely focus on the task in hand without any distraction to all. So this is the benefit of VR. But we can see the VR, what is the help of VR before, pre, post, and during the crisis itself? In pre or before, it's help in hazard prevention and recognition, also safety training. So because we know that there will be a crisis. So هناك بتكون يعني أزمة either natural or biological or whatever. So how I can train these people for the safety, to take any precautions, whatever, all these things. So this AR and VR, augmented reality and virtual reality, can help. This is the time for it. During the crisis, of course, for the human evacuation, we can يعني, guide them directly. And search and rescue. To search and rescue during the crisis, if it's possible, of course. After, we can know the damage detection and building reconstruction. Holography and 3D. We see what is holography. Of course, holography, it's a 3D. Of course, it's a 3D only, 3D photography. And it represents 3D views with changing perspectives. What's called the technology or the output or the technology is called holograms. I am sure most of you hear about the holograms. The benefits here, the digital technology of holograms has paved a new way to conduct conferences and live events. How? It ensures to reduce exposure of the speakers, employees, and also the clients, the attendance audience. Like now, if we are using holography, maybe will be nice, maybe different than now you are reading and hearing only. So of course, thousands of people can attend live streaming at the same time. And there is also biosensors. What is biosensor? This is a biological. The sensors of the biological, and we saw this is about the sensor measuring the temperature. Sometimes you can put your sensor, and this sensor is in direct reading to the doctor, your doctor, your specialist doctor, and that doctor can prescribe the medicine to you and return back by sending a message in your mobile or your smart mobile. We have to say smart because not just any mobile, smart device. So you can read this prescription or instruction, not or you print the prescription and go to the medicine. But if you are in a smart city or the Tobia city, then you can send another sensor. So the drone will bring the medicine to your place. This is the capable of providing the devices which can be easily to employ sensitive, cost saving, and can provide high accuracy. Mobile phones, voice, text, locations, applications, cameras, we have seen all this one, how it's used. Live, we can record live streaming, talking, sending messages, even the posting. This is social media, also social media, but it came in different things. So this is our life, it's a mobile phones. Drones, of course, drones are, we know that, what is drones? Drones that vehicle that don't have a human occupant. Yani self-driving, but either flying, what's called unmanned air vehicles, or underwater, what's unmanned underwater vehicles. We can see this one. But this is drones are in use for surveillance and monitoring, استكشاف والمتابعة, transportation is used, transportation, and مثلا لما الإشراف, يعني إيش فائدة الدرونز؟ إحنا شفنا في اللوك داونز إنه لازم كل واحد يلبس كمام. During the lockdown, يعني there's totally curfew, no one go out from his home. So maybe drones, it can do this task for the police or for the officers to see and write offense or fine for the people. Transportation, we see transportation of the post, transportation of the medication, transportation of the food, of course, with the few less weight. An area spraying. During the crisis, we know this is it's expected that the network will be disconnected. So if the network is disconnected, how the people, they are going to connect to the world? And I remember that during the last cyclone, when my uncle has a farm there, and he was recording and watching what's going in his farm till the electricity, that I mean that the electricity is got disconnected. So electricity or the network, that's mean, so the drones can do this area for area spraying in the for the network. For unmanned air vehicles, what's the unmanned air vehicles? This is the unmanned air vehicles. This is the drone. We talk about it. It's easy for transportation, for monitoring, and also for the aerial spraying. This is for the air. The underwater one, this one, what's the benefit for this one? يعني ممكن شكلها كغواصة, هي احنا نشوفها انها كغواصة, لكن هي كان يعني فيها sensors وتعمل مثلا major storm intensity and directions. ايضا GPS, هنا يعني واحدة من disadvantage or challenges, GPS does not work underwater. So, هذا اللي هو underwater are tethered, limiting their range. Going back for the blockchain, what's useful of blockchain? Blockchain fundraising activity that accept cryptocurrencies, also coordinating and verifying information among different stakeholders. لأن نعرف إحنا مثلاً during the crisis وشفنا مثلاً في أثناء when Juno was affecting the capital, إنه كثير من قواعد البيانات راحن. فهذا واحدة منهن, يعني إنه لما يكون safe in blockchain, يعني it will be totally secured and safe. Social media, we see how the effect of Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat during, before and during and after the crisis. Crowdsourcing and crowdfunding. And definitely there are some examples has been used here in the world for all of these technologies. Yeah, and for example, even for the Twitter, India used Twitter during its I think when the disaster in 2015. Also US and another part of the world, Japan used robotics. And the other part of the world, each one they have used a different technology. And in Oman, for example, last time they have used the drones. As we see in the news, they use drone to deliver the post, to deliver few things only. Of course, not a huge with the huge weight, with the less weight. But at least even if it was a trial, but it was successful. Cloud computing. Yes, regarding the drones, we see that been used, and also in Vanuatu in 2015. Yes, this Vanuatu has been affected by a volcanic. It's an island in Republic in Melanesia. Cloud computing. It's a digital technology which involves the delivery of computer system resources over the internet, such as server, storage, databases, networking, intelligence, and so on. The benefit in the present time of social isolation amid outbreak, people have been able to continue their digital lives with the help, of course, of the application, like what, like Zoom, like now here, what we are using, Team, like anyone that VoIP applications. Also cloud computing can be helpful to fight against crises in several ways. And even the crisis, when you call it crisis, about even technological crisis. So it can be fight against it. We talk about drones, IoT, VR. Now, after we have seen about the technologies and benefit for the crisis management, what are the challenges or of 4IR technologies? Of course, there is a gap in technical skills. نلاحظ يعني معانا انه يعني not most of the people are in the level that can use or deal with these technologies. Data sensitivity. لكن الحين احنا قادمين مع الاوبن داتا والاوبن سورس فاتوقع ربما لابد فيها حل هذه. ايضا الانتروبرابيليتي سيكيورتي ديفينيتلي ذا سيكيورتي اند هاندلنج داتا جروث. Handling data growth, we saw that we reached to the zeta byte. So after that zeta byte, what it will be, the size of the data. Data deluge, one of the challenges. False information, of course, if we have false information is coming to this, and we said that the accuracy of the data is one of the factors or characteristics of the big data. So data false information or false information is not required in these things. طبعا data deluge, if there is over and over, so we need to increase the size of the database. Readiness, of course, we have to be readiness. Ownership, who is going to own the technology, of course, not even the technologies, who is going to own this, the big data, the data itself. So it will be handled. The cloud, let me see the cloud server. So all the data coming or combined or consolidated in one database. The cost of these technologies, we know it's high, it's really costly. Connectivity, we have seen. Connectivity is one issue, major issue. If there is no network connectivity, there is no work of these technologies. Also for the connectivity, we can see even the electricity also. Regulation, legal and regulations. Yes, we see it cannot bring any technology and use. And we have seen when we get drones, طبعا لأنه في bad use for the drones. People were using it over the homes. So private homes is not accepted, of course, this one. But يعني في تشريعات. طبعا لكون انه هذه التقنيات كلها تقنيات جديدة فالتشريعات اصلا تجي تتوالى مع هذه التقنيات وبعد فهم هذه التقنيات. لكن still انه هي فيها challenges تعتبر واحدة من challenges حتى يتم استخدام. And thank you very much. شكرا لكم على to bear me your time. وأتمنى يعني I wish you get some useful information. Please, if you have any other useful information you can share, I will learn from you. يعني سوري على التقصير إذا كان في missing information I didn't deliver to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Salem, for a very interesting session on the application of IR technology in the crisis management. It was really very interesting and a lot of information. In fact, we are beyond the time, but we'll open the floor for maybe a couple of questions. If any of the attendees have any question, they might unmute themselves or raise their hand.
طبعا دكتوره الحين بعد الوقت يعني طبعا كل سؤال يكون مدفوع.
اوكي استاذه انا مش دكتوره دكتور. Let us see if there is any question. The topic was very well explained. That's maybe there is no question.
Or other thing, maybe I didn't explain it well.
إذا ما شاء الله ما شاء الله ما قصر دكتور.
Seems there is no question from all.
They can unmute, but I will allow microphone for all the attendees.
They can raise hand.
Yeah, they can raise hand, but let us see if anyone is interested. So far, no question. Like in Doctor, I have a question myself regarding the. The crowdfunding platforms. هل الإعلانات للدونيشن لضحايا الفيضان والسايكلون هل هي تعتبر من نوع من أنواع شو اسمه الكراود فاندينج بلاتفورمز ولا something else؟
بالضبط
disconnection في الصوت دكتور
الصوت disconnected social development يعني to be So disconnected?
أيوة الحين أوكي الحين باك.
أوكي يعني في كان تعميم من وزارة التنمية social development minister of social development regarding this one to be careful not any advertising coming to us that we should believe it.
Okay, so is that what you call it the crowdfunding platforms?
Yes, crowdfunding اللي هو يعني التمويل الجماعي يعني التمويل المجتمعي.
Okay. Thank you, doctor.
شكرا محفوظ.
Yeah, so I believe the topic was well explained and there are no questions. It's now safe to end our session. At the end of this very interesting session, I will ask you all to join me to thank Dr. Salem Al-Shaili for his remarkable session on harnessing IR for technologies in crisis management. And I would remind you all, please, to fill the survey in the chat. Thank you very much. شكرا جزيلا دكتور أحسنت وبارك الله فيك ما قصرت.
شكرا للجميع ونتمنى لكم إن شاء الله وقت سعيد إن شاء الله. شكرا جميعا.
مع السلامة.
شكرا للحضور جميعا.
شكرا.